MuseScore Studio 4.5 is here, and it's packed with game-changing updates for your music creation workflow. Whether you're a seasoned composer or just getting started, let me show you what's new in version 4.5, starting with dynamics. Input dynamics faster than ever before. Simply select a note and press Ctrl-D or Command-D on Mac. Choose a dynamic from this pop-up and it's added instantly. This also makes it really easy to edit existing dynamics. For even faster entry, type your dynamic directly into this text box. Need a hairpin? Click this handle to drag out a crescendo or diminuendo. If you're dragging towards another dynamic, the correct hairpin will be chosen automatically. You can also hold Alt or Option X to reverse it, keeping you focused on your score and your music. Now, if you're a Finale user, here's a few features we've made with you in mind. MuseScore Studio now supports drag and drop copy and paste. Hold Alt or Option while dragging with your mouse to easily copy music across staves or to any beat position. For even more control over your score layout, you can also move measures between systems with a simple shortcut or with a click of these buttons in Properties. You can even lock systems to prevent reflow further down the page. In version 4.5, we're introducing Input by Duration mode, which will feel familiar to Finale Speedy Entry users. Preview pitches with your computer or MIDI keyboard and input them with duration shortcuts 1 through 7. We've also made a range of improvements to note input, which you can learn about in a new tutorial video in the Learn tab. And now we're really excited to introduce our redesigned percussion panel, featuring a modern drum pad style interface that can be customized to your preferred layout. Switch between instrument names and notation previews, add custom shortcuts, and hide unused pads for a cleaner view. We've also made percussion input faster than ever. Simply click a pad to add a note or input notation directly on the stave with your mouse. The new panel is also fully accessible for keyboard-only users. Best of all, MuseScore Studio adapts the drum pad layout to reflect your chosen sound library, ensuring accurate notation and playback every time. This makes it the perfect tool for our new percussion libraries, including exclusive MuseSounds editions of Audio Imperia's Epic Cerberus and Audio Ollie's hard-hitting LA Modern Percussion, available soon in MuseHub. And from our own collection of MuseSounds instruments, we're introducing two new percussion combo instruments that cover the full spectrum of general MIDI. With these, you can conveniently work with a wide selection of percussion instruments on a single stave while enjoying the exceptional playback of MuseSounds. All this is just the next step in the evolution of our percussion system, and we'll be introducing even more workflow and integration improvements in the near future. Now, as always, there's a huge number of new engraving features in this update to help you effortlessly create professional-looking scores. Let me show you what's new in version 4.5. Text elements like dynamics, lyrics, expression text, and more can now pass through barlines with automatic masking, which is especially helpful when there's a lot of notation to include in tight spaces. We've also introduced laisser vibrer ties. Expose this option via the customized toolbar pop-up and add them with a single click. You can change their style, position, and length in properties, and you'll be able to hear their effects in playback. We've even made regular ties respond more intelligently at repeated sections and jumps. They'll now be automatically entered wherever a note of the same pitch appears at the start of a jump, and you can control which notes get tied with this handy pop-up. Slurs and lyric extension lines can also be extended across repeats using some handy shortcuts. Finally, MuseScore Studio now automatically creates courtesy clefs, key and time signatures at repeats and jumps, something that no other music notation app currently does. You'll find new options for controlling this behavior in the style dialog. Now, here's some good news for band and orchestral composers. Large time signatures are finally here. Head over to Format Style to choose between different styles and positions. You'll also have more control over where system markings like rehearsal or tempo marks appear. Just use copy and paste to show them above different staves. Fine-tune which markings appear where in the newly updated Layout panel, which is formerly called Instruments. There's so much more to explore in MuseScore Studio 4.5, and we can't wait to see how you use these new features. As always, we're grateful to our strong community of testers and developers, and would like to acknowledge in particular GitHub users Aniketo, CMakeScore, Pachebes, Krasko, and many more for contributing to various features and improvements in this release. We also invite you to check out our brand new handbook in Gitbook for more details on any of the features covered in this video, and be sure to look out for new tutorials coming soon to the Learn tab. Please subscribe to our channel, and thank you for using MuseScore Studio.